Windows Azure Multi-Factor Authentication can be used to secure on-premises and cloud applications using the Multi-Factor Authentication SDK. Developers can use the SDK to add multi-factor to SaaS applications, customer-facing websites, and employee applications like HR portals. When users sign into your app, they use their existing account credentials. The app validates the username and password, then sends a request to the Multi-Factor Authentication cloud service via the SDK. The service sends the authentication request to the user's phone or mobile device. Once the user has authenticated, a result is returned to the app so that the user can be signed in. The SDK is available in a number of languages, including C#, VB.NET, Java, Perl, PHP, and Ruby. To get started with the Windows Azure Multi-Factor Authentication SDK, log in to the Windows Azure Management Portal. Go to your Active Directory tenant. Click Multi-Factor Auth Providers and manage your provider. You can then click the SDK link and download the appropriate SDK. Once the SDK has been downloaded and unzipped, you're ready to get started. While the various SDKs may look a little different from the C# SDK shown here, the basic components are the same in each. Here, you can see some files that are useful to the developer, such as a README file, example code, and a definition of call results. The code that you will integrate into your application is in the PF folder. Here you see a single class file that is added to your Visual Studio project. The search folder contains a client certificate that is used to mutually authenticate to the multi-factor authentication service when requesting an authentication to be performed. The path to this certificate is referenced when you request an authentication. Let's take a look at some of the resources and code. The call results file describes the result codes you may get back from the multi-factor authentication service. You can choose to handle all denied authentications in the same way, or to take different actions based on the result code. The example code is for a basic web form that illustrates ways to request the different types of authentication. First, you instantiate the PF auth params object and populate it. Then you pass that object into the PF authentication function to request the multi-factor authentication. If we take a look at the class file that you include in your project, you can see the PF auth params class that is populated with data that tells the multi-factor authentication service how to perform your authentication. Parameters that you populate include a username, which is any unique ID for the user, a phone number, and a mode of authentication. The PF auth class includes some comments to describe what each of the parameters are that are used in the PF auth params object and passed into the PF authenticate function. Integrating the multi-factor authentication SDK into your code is a straightforward process. You'll be up and running in no time.